Hey student, in previous session we discussed how income comparison between two countries or states. See, we discuss which is a rich country, which one is a poor country, all those things. So you might be thinking, sir, how can we decide which is the rich and which is the poor country? So what is the criteria of the amount? See, WDR, the World Development Report, they brought to from to take a data from the BB, the World Bank, from the World Bank, and they decide as per the US dollar. You know, each international market the based on the dollars, US dollar, right? As per the US dollar, which country has the 12,055? Which country has the per capita income, the $12,055? That country might be the rich country. And 55 and above, this country might be the rich country, and we can say the developed country. Which country has the 12,000, the $55 per capita income? That country is the rich and the developed country. And which country has the less than US dollar? 995. Which country has the $995 per capita income? That country might be the poor country. That country might be the poor country. This data according to the 2017. Per year. 2016-17 financial year. Which country has the 12,055 per capita income in annual? Which country has the dollar, US dollar, 995 per capita income is called is a poor country. So, sir, when is India? Where was the India? India has around 6,925 around $6,925. We are the developed country and the poor country. We are the middle country. We are always the developing country. Already, I told you, we are already developed country. It still goes on the another 40 years. It might be now we are going into due to the pandemic, there will be a huge result will be there. But India is the fastest growing economy. India was the fastest growing economy in the world. For the place to be the Prime Minister Modi. Right. So these are the criteria. So we decide which is the rich country and which is the poor country. Next week right, decide income and other criteria. Already we paid the total income of the country. We not calculated due to the and per capita also we paid. Already we explained the gap. So the income is must. Income is must. Each and every country has income is must. Is income and other criteria. What were the other criteria? What is it? See, if this take a this man, this graph, this table, one is Haryana state, we consider this Haryana, and another is Himachal Pradesh, and third one is the Bihar. The per capita NSDP, NSDP means net state domestic product, the net state domestic product. We say our GDP, right, sir? GDP. GDP is the within a year in the country. Within a year, the country, the what are the producing the goods and services? The amount of the goods and services is our GDP. So, net state domestic product, GDP means gross domestic product. The Haryana's NSDP, 1,80,174, and Himachal's 1,49,028, and Bihar only 34,000. Everyone knows the Bihar very poorest state in the India. He is called as Chhattisgarh also. The Bihar NSDP is 34,000. When it comes to the Haryana's lakhs. See, Himachal here, 1,49,000. But when it considers Telangana, around 2 lakh. See, but these are the, you can see that Haryana is the most developed state. As per, according to the NSDP. In Himachal is the length, and when it's the poorest state in the Bihar. But these are the criteria, they match to the same, which state is the developed, but we have to fail in the, when you compare with the countries, right now. These are the, GDP is not compared with the perfect aspect to the, which country is the poor, which country is the very rich. But when it comes to the Haryana, is the richest. But when it comes to other criteria, what were they, Nana? The state in the Haryana is IMR. These are the very important. These are the criteria considered. these are the criteria considered. With income and this criteria will perfectly match, then we decide which country is the developed and which are the poorest country. This is when it comes to state Haryana 2016. Haryana, IMR is 33. IMR is the infant mortality rate. IMR is the infant mortality rate. Infant mortality rate. You know what is the infant mortality rate? Infant mortality rate means those who are the newly born child. The newly born child. The die rate of the newly born child. The die rate of a born child. Born child per thousand. Per thousand. We can see in the Nirmal area, the thousand children will born. Thousand children born. Among the thousand, only 900 will survive. 900 survive. And 100 child will be dies. 100 child will be the dies. See, this is the IMR. This is the rate. The every thousand, each thousand, in the thousand children born, how many will be the die? This rate will be considered the IMR. This rate will be considered IMR. IMR means infant mortality rate. Infant mortality rate. You have thousand of the amount. You have the amount of the lakh per capita income is 1,80,174. But when it comes to the Haryana, IMR mortality rate 33 will be lost. You have the huge amount of in your account, in your balance. But you might, those who are not surviving 33 children, where the only out of the 1,000, what is the use of that? What is the use of that amount? Same here. This is the IMR. When it comes to the Himachal, Himachal has 1,49,028. But the only 25,000, only 25 children were being the dies in the IMR. Only 25 children. But when it comes to the Haryana, Bihar, there is a 38. You can consider the 38 children, newly born children, we can't survive their life. They can't survive their life. But when next, literacy rate. The next, literacy rate. Literacy rate in Ghana, those who are the above 7 years, those who are the above 7 years, they get able to read and write. Those who are able to read and write above 7 years is considered the literacy rate. This is considered literacy rate. We can see that those who are able to read and write and understood what they are the writing and what they are the reading, those who are above 7 years, those who are considered the literacy rate. In the literacy rate, only 77%. Haryana 77%, Himachal is 84%. Himachal is 84%. But when it comes to the net attendance, net attendance means those who are considered 9th and 10th class. 9th and 10th class, those who are the student going to school, 9th and 10th, those who are how much percentage they are attendance in the per year. When it comes to the Haryana, 61%, Himachal 67%, and Bihar 43%. Bihar 43%. So now you can comparison. Now you can comparison. Know that Bihar is the poorest state. But when it comes to the Haryana and Himachal, when it comes to NSDP, the Haryana is the richest state. Haryana is the developed state. But when it comes to the other criteria, what are the IMR, literacy rate, and attendance, net attendance? So now you can see the which kind of state is the developed state, Himachal Pradesh. Why? Because IMR rate is very low when you compare to Haryana. Literacy rate is high. When it compares to the Haryana, attendance rate is high when it compares to the Haryana. So now doubt at all. So this other criteria is considered. Is the Himachal is the developed state. Why this consider is important? Na only we can consider is the developed is with the income. No, you have a income, but you don't have the survive the child. What is the benefit? You have a income, but you don't understand what government, what you are running the business, what going on the around. So what is the benefit? You have the income, but you don't want to study, then how can you survive in the 21st century? That is no use. So when this consider this all things without income, then we decided which is a developed state, which is not. But when it comes to our Telangana, IMR 31. See, everyone our We are the developed country. We are the developed state, the richest state. What we have richest state? We are nearby the Bihar. We are nearby the Bihar. Out of the 1000. So this is the these are the data of the 2016. But when it comes to the Telangana, this is the 2019 data. This is the 2019 data. See, the we are the only closest to the Bihar. 31. We are the 31 in the IMR rate. But the infant mortality rate. When it comes to literacy rate, 72. We are in each and every person here going to school nowadays. And we are attendance in the 94%. Attendance in the 94%. So these are income and these are the criteria. These are the calculated for the which contains the state, which is the good and bad.